Hi everyone, welcome to Vasari Talk. My name is Lilli Smith, and today we are coming to you live from Cambridge, Massachusetts, where Zach Kron is with five of his students from MIT. We have Stefano Andriani, Argo Jati, Patrick Little, Vernell Noel, and Jay Lee. And thanks so much, guys, for all joining us today.
Hi everybody.
Hello.
Hey everyone.
Today we're going to discuss their work in Zach and Dennis Shelden's class, Digital Fabrication and Construction. The students will present their case studies of Gensler's Shanghai Tower and Herzog & Demiron's Beijing National Stadium. They'll explain how they built parametric study models using Vasari and then how they leveraged those models for additional analysis. As always, we welcome your questions. Please enter them in the GoToWebinar question box. And we will be offering one AI learning unit for today's class. So if you'd like to receive credit, please stick around until the end where we'll have a brief survey and you can tell us your thoughts about today's session and enter your AIA number. We'll be recording today's session and we will post it on our Vasari Talk Wiki very soon. And so now I will hand it over to you, Zach.
Great, thanks. See. All right. Can folks see me?
Yes. Look good.
Great. Yeah, let me just blow this up. So first of all, the class itself, which I was very lucky to be able to have a hand in, is very much Dennis's class. He's been teaching this for a number of years out here at MIT, and it's a class that sort of has changed every year, and it's a morphing and growing and evolving. Traditionally, it has been a class about looking at parametric systems and parametric building components, how pieces of a building and the logic of how they go together can be studied, how the logic has implications for fabrication. It's pretty far flung in its ambitions, and it was a really exciting class to be involved in. For me, I was a step up from tech support. Getting people up and running on what was, for the class, a bit of an experiment. It's been traditionally done in CATIA and Digital Project. Dennis wanted to give it a try with doing it in Revit and Vasari this year to see how far that particular parametric tool could be pushed. There was a very healthy serving of Rhino and Grasshopper, as we're also going to see in the projects that the students are going to walk through. And just to sort of tell you a little bit about what the course trajectory was, there were three exercises. There was a first sort of quick sketch that the students were doing just to sort of dip their toes into how to use parametric systems and how to use them to understand building components and building systems. And the exercise was to sort of go back and forth between creating a physical model, trying to recreate it in a digital system, and then pushing the digital system to the point of failure and then trying to recreate that kind of failure mode in a physical model. So again, just sort of trying to sort of understand how parametric systems can be used to understand real systems and the real physicality of fabrication processes. The midterm presentation, which is largely what we're going to be talking about today, actually, Dennis very wisely tries to get as much work out of the students early on before everybody gets into crunch time around finals. So for this particular part of the assignment, students basically did a precedent study. They picked out famous buildings that they liked. They dissected it into a number of different sort of component pieces to look at how particular building systems would go together. And they would make physical and digital prototypes of this. And then they would try and do a reconfiguration of that system. And they used a number of different tools. They tried to do some amount of it in Vasari. They also did some Grasshopper models, which is all pretty exciting. People tried to do sort of identical things in both platforms sometimes and sort of see what kind of results they had in one, what kind of results they had in another. So there was a lot of experimentation there. And then for the final presentation, it was sort of throwing all the cards up in the air in some ways. People could do an entirely new project if they wanted to. We've got on the lower left, we've got a student who did a study of berms and water flow. We've got a guy who did some inflatable architecture that was pretty exciting. There was some lamp making. There was a library that was used to house manuscripts. So students were really able to explore sort of more broadly from their original case studies, or as the students here did as well, sort of go more deeply into the case studies that they did earlier. And with that, I actually just want to turn it over to the students so they can start showing their work, and we can get into some questions about these after each student group does their presentations, and then we'll probably also have some type of questions at the end. So right now I'm going to turn it over to Jay and Brunel, and I'm going to change you guys to presenter. And if you could say a little bit about yourself.